That was a piece called, I'll send you a postcard, and it was actually written about a dear friend of mine who went on his journeys a few years ago. And that when I left him for the last time, that was what he said to me, I'll send you a postcard, which I rather liked, so I wrote that about. It's glorious to be here, and I'm not going to talk too much. That makes them laugh, because normally they know that I talk for hours. I'd like to introduce you to someone who's come along to sing a couple of songs. The first one he's going to sing is was written by myself and by Sam Brown, the girl singer. So it's written for a lady to sing, but tonight we're going to have a gentleman sing it. What a fine voice. A guy from this wonderful country of yours, Mr. Jørn Lande. Please welcome him on stage, if you would be so kind, with Natalie Lorix and Nina, what's her name? Rob, come along.
Thank you. voice. Hopefully you can hear it within here. Okay. Because we, the Trondheim Soloists, we have been very lucky to be working with you several times now. And it's great fun, it's a great experience, and we're very happy about it. And you have inspired us in many ways. Actually so much that one of us has written a piece to you. So that is sitting there in the viola section, Johannes Rusten. Please rise. When he heard we were going to work with you again, he just sat down and wrote this piece. So if you don't mind, we'll play it for you. You sit down. We play. It's called In Beautiful Moments. So I guess that has something to do with our work together. Enjoy In Beautiful Moments by Johannes Rusten.
conductor says you can talk. I think you have to remember that name, Johannes Rusten. That's a composer. Thank you, Johannes. I'm very touched. We're going to put a choir in place. So we're going to play one more piece before we do the choir piece, without talking to you. Let these ladies and gentlemen get comfortable at the back. And I'll tell you the story of this next piece, which is, again, just for the orchestra. It started like a 3-minute piece for string quartet.
Very quickly. Jesus inspired that.
I woke up with a little, just those little notes rattling around in my head. So I wrote them down and it made a small string piece. Then when I was doing an album a couple of years ago with these fine people, and I lengthened the piece to about 7 or 8 minutes. And then at the end of last year, I was recording it in Denmark with the Odense Symphony Orchestra. And a dear friend of mine, actually from this part of the world, had said, that tune in the middle, can you make it a bit longer? Because, you know, I like to whistle it or whatever. So I just made the tune a bit longer. But this is my final thoughts on this piece. And are you guys all right standing? It's got a very quite difficult part for a solo violin, which is going to be played by Sveinung, who now I think really understands my mum. I think he understands her better than I ever did. And occasionally there is a sort of a smaller voice from the solo cello, played by Øivind Gimse, who is just one of the best cellists I ever heard in my life. And that is a slightly smaller voice, and that's my dad. It's called Music for Miriam.
Thank you.
little bit. He mustn't come on unannounced, so please welcome him to the stage. In about 1998, I was working on an idea only for some sort of music to celebrate the coming millennium. And I had a few jotted ideas, a few words, a few chords, a couple of tunes. And I was visited by a friend of mine who's the vicar of the local churches. And he's here tonight, Paul Nicolson. And he's traveled all the way to come hear this baby. And he wanted me to write something for our local churches to involve the local children. To celebrate the millennium in our area. So I showed him these two or three words that I had about hope and peace and love and understanding, because I'm an old hippie, you see. And his words just mean a lot. And Paul got very excited and he went off and wrote a beautiful prayer, which I think you'll find printed. Wonderful book that Andy did. And we played it in the early part of 2000. And it's been played a couple of times since, but never by professional forces. So here tonight it gets its professional debut. It's really a cry for a better world, I think, in a simple way. And if you're of faith, or if you're of any faith, or if you're of no faith at all, it still, I think, will speak. I hope it speaks up. The words will speak for what we need to make this earth of ours as habitable as we possibly can. I hope you enjoy it, and we've certainly enjoyed rehearsing it. Let's see what happens. Thank you very much indeed for being here tonight. And this is From Darkness to Light.